Vulnerable foreign workers can apply for an open work permit in Canada. In doing so, they're not tied to their abusive employer anymore, and with their open work permit, they can work for any employer in Canada. In this video, I will share details about this vulnerable worker open work permit, who can apply for it, the requirements for it, and what's next. If you're a Canadian employer who's hiring foreign workers, or if you're a foreign worker who's looking to work in Canada, both of you can benefit from this information, as non-compliant employers may be fined thousands of dollars and may be banned for several years from hiring a foreign worker in Canada. And I will also leave a link to download the employer compliance checklist and a report on non-compliance in this video. If this is your first time here, my name is Rashid Ali. I'm a licensed Canadian immigration consultant from Milton, Canada. In this channel, I share videos on Canadian immigration, visas, and citizenship. This is generic information and should not be considered legal advice because the circumstances of each applicant are very different. For advice that is specific and relevant to you, feel free to schedule a consultation. I will leave a link in the description. So when we say vulnerable workers, what does that mean? Who are vulnerable workers? They are those who are facing abuse or at the risk of facing abuse in relation to their job in Canada. And the definition of abuse as per IRCC is any behavior that scares, controls, or isolates you could be abuse. Abuse can be physical, sexual, financial, or mental. Examples of abuse are physical harm, forcing you to do work that's not safe, unsanitary or unsafe living conditions in employer-provided housing, touching that you did not agree to or making unwanted comments, controlling where you can go, stealing from you, stopping you from seeing friends or co-workers, taking some or all of the money you are paid, threats, insults, intimidation, forcing you to commit fraud, a third party charging you a fee for a job, or making promises that aren't real. And you can imagine some of these things, like a third party charging you a fee for a job or the employer taking your money. This is what happens when people try to buy LMIAs. They try to buy jobs, which is illegal. So that's bad for you, and it can be very bad for the employer and all the parties involved. That's why I really discourage the practice of buying jobs. It's illegal. It's better to go look for legitimate jobs. I leave a couple of videos in the description so you can check those out and learn more about how to do it. To apply for this open work permit for vulnerable workers, you have to be inside Canada. Your current closed work permit must be valid, and you can only apply if you're being abused or at the risk of being abused in relation to your job. And if you're not clear about what closed and open work permit means, a closed work permit means that you can only work for a particular employer whose name is listed in your work permit. An open work permit means that you can basically work for any employer in Canada. You can leave a job, get another job. It's open. You don't have to inform IRCC. You don't have to get a new work permit to change employers. That's the concept of an open work permit. In your application, you have to explain the abuse and should attach as much evidence as you can. Some of the examples for this evidence could be a letter or a statement or a report from an abuse support organization, a doctor, healthcare professionals. It could be a sworn statement or an affidavit from yourself. It could be an official report you submitted to an enforcement agency like police or CBSA. It could be in the form of email or text messages, pay stubs or bank statements that show some sort of abuse. It could be photos showing injuries or working conditions. It could be a witness testimonies. These are just some of the evidences that you could provide in support of your application. A good step by IRCC is that on their website related to vulnerable workers page, they have this exit this page quickly button. So if you're reading about that information and your abuser is constantly monitoring you, looking at your screen, you can quickly move out of that page. They also advise on that page that applicants should delete their browser history if their abuser monitors it. So IRCC is really trying to be supportive to the applicants who are being abused. And you can apply for this open work permit online through IRCC secure account or the GC key account. And if you have a representative, of course, they can apply on your behalf as well. And IRCC prioritizes this application and they will get in touch with you very quickly. If you have dependent family members who are already with you in Canada, they can also be included in this application. So you don't have to worry about your family who's with you in Canada. There is also no government fee for this application, and the work permit is typically issued for a period of 1 year. You can then find another job during this time period and apply for a closed work permit. Or if applicable, you can apply for a PR. You cannot extend this open work permit. By the way, if you're someone who's looking to visit, study, or immigrate to Canada, we'll be launching an online community later this year where you can connect with other professionals such as yourself, share your ideas, experiences with each other, ask questions. And if you're someone who's already here and you're looking to support your family and friends in their journey to Canada, this will also be a good place to do that. There will be an application process for that. So if you're interested, I will leave a link in the description so you can apply to join this community. security. I'll share an example with you about what can be potentially construed as a vulnerable worker who's being abused. There was a person who told me that their employer was really mistreating them. They were really micromanaging them. They were literally looking at the screen the whole time. Like, they turned the screen of the employee towards themselves, like in their direction, so they can monitor their actions. They were not paying them well enough. The employer was exploiting the employee in other ways as well. So if someone is monitoring your actions very closely, not letting you take breaks, not letting you talk to your co-workers or colleagues, this is also a form of abuse. There were some other issues with this particular employer as well. So this employee then filed for an open work permit. They were then asked to appear for an in-person interview with IRCC at Ottawa. There the officer asked them some more questions about their circumstances to validate the information that they had shared, and then their application was approved. They were given an open work permit for 1 year. Now that employer will probably go through an audit, and they probably won't be able to hire foreign workers for some time in the future and may also be fined. So if you are an employer hiring foreign workers, please understand your obligations and responsibilities. I'm attaching a quick employer compliance checklist, which contains a list of documents also that you as an employer may be asked to present during a compliance audit. Also, you'll find a report about employer non-compliance. Links are in the description. And if you're a vulnerable employee, you don't have to take abuse anymore. Please look into this program. If you would like to speak to me, please schedule a consultation so we can plan a way forward. That's all for today. Take care.